Hi, my name is Saul Montoya from Hatari Water, and this time we are going to do a tutorial how to represent water chemistry data on QGIS. So we have a set of data and we want to represent and we want to do some stuff in order to analyze it or maybe to plot it or generate some maps. So here we have the four tasks that we are going to do. We are going to plot bicarbonates, we are going to plot surface from the data that we are going to open, and then we're going to do a triangular interpolation of surface, and then we will have the surface concentration contours, and then we are going to explore an illustration. If illustration is kind of a quick map of QGIS that is very handful if you want to do a report, like if you want to do a PowerPoint presentation. Okay, so let's begin. We open. In the description of this video, you will find this Datos Química shapefile. It's here, and then we are going to plot the bicarbonate. First, we are going to change the name because, like, this layer will be called bicarbonate. Okay. Then we go zoom to kappa, zoom to layer. Sorry. Maybe something more here. Okay. And okay, cool. So we are going to put a we are going to set a color degree where the higher concentration will be a more solid color, like more vivid color, and then the other one will be more shaded color. So we go to properties. Wait. And then we say from unique sample to graduated, and then we go to bicarbonates, and then if we say equal interval, like if we put classify here, this is equal interval is not a good option because we have like values that range from 0 to 700, and if you see the 700 values, maybe it could be two values, so and this could affect your scale. So it's better to use like natural ruptures of Jenks. It's cool, it's better. And nothing else, so we put accept that, and then here we have the distribution of bicarbonates. Great. So then we are going to duplicate because we are going to do not bicarbonates but we are going to do sulfates, and this is just to duplicate the representation because in fact we are not doing anything with the data. The data it stays the same. So here we change the name, change to sulfates, and then here in sulfates we go to properties. No, wait. Okay, and then we select surfaces, and then we go to greens, maybe greens, and then we put classify. Thus, if we put classify, it do automatically the classification, and then we are doing again natural raptors with Jenks. We put apply, and then here we have the classification options, but we wanted to do a scale, so we wanted that the biggest concentrations will be in the biggest concentrations will be with a higher size, and the smaller concentration will be lower in size. So in order to do that, we go to properties. And then we just there were some options before, I don't know how it changed, but there were some options that do it automatically. Since we have just four categories, it's not such a big deal to do this. We do right click here, and then we put this is will be times 5, this will be 4. Three, 2, this is already 2, and this is 1. And that gives more value to your data, because now that you can see the hot spots of the sulfates, and then if the concentration is lower, like you don't see like on the like a big on your map. So yeah, I think that this is a cool option in order to do your spatial analysis. Now again with the plan, we want to do a triangular interpolation of sulfates. So what we do is here in raster, we do raster interpolation, we go sulfates, and then we go, this is in fact the name, I mean, because both are the same spatial data, so we can do both. Well, the attribute table of both are the same because we didn't set any filter. So we have here HCO3. No, sulfates, and then we put at, and then here we have sulfates points, triangular interpolation. These parameters for default are okay, and then we go to say raster of sulfates, and then we put save, and then we put, and then I say add results to the project. Yes, interpolation seems ugly. And the maybe if you want to do some like more professional stuff, you will need to do a kriging. We have a tutorial to do kriging as well, but this kriging is in SAGIS. This is entirely in QGIS. So well, this is with the data we have and the tools we have. Okay, so here once again we are going to do we go to raster, and then we go to extraction, and then we go to curva de nivel. In curva de nivel we go to raster surface because it's the only raster that we have, and then we go here to the folder where we are working. And then we put contours of sulfates. Contours of sulfates. Cool. And then we didn't put the attribute name, like you, it will export the contour but not export the value, the metadata, or like as attribute. And it's better always to put an attribute name. Okay? And then here we have our isolines. Cool. Then we don't need this, we just turn it off, the raster. And the surface, we put it on the back. And then again, we are going to do some style with the surface. We are double click and wait. We are going to put graduated, and then we select surface. And then we select greens because we were plotting the circuits with greens. We jenks. I think it's okay. And we put apply. And then here we have these isolines of sulfates. And then maybe we can put the label because we want to see how is the interpreted surface concentration. And then we put with this option, we put the label, and then we put these sulfates. Then I don't want it in black, I want it in gray. Okay, and here are the sulfates interpolation. So what we have done, this, the contours, yeah. And then we are going to do illustration. What is illustration? Illustration is, in fact, is a feature of QGIS that could do quick maps, because there is another option to do maps. So if you want to do to finish this tutorial, we go to Ver, Ilustraciones, View, Illustrations, and then we can put a great quadricule. Ah, cool. This is in fact because the canvas is on, you cannot see, but it's on, maybe Maybe it's important. The canvas is on geographical, yep. But if we want to see the quadrature as meters, we have to change the spatial reference coordinates of the center, like to WGS UTM 17S, and then like now our quadrature could be in meters because it's better. So we go here, illustration quadricules. And here our quadrature is in meters. Yep. I think that the letter is huge. So and here we can put horizontal and vertical. And then the size of the letter is big. So I put an 8. Yeah, why not? Maybe as a 10. Okay, and then the line is in black and I want it in gray. Nothing else. So illustrations help us as well as to put the north arrow. So illustrations north arrow, so we wanted to put it in up left. Up left and then activate. Okay, and once again, in illustrations, I want to put a scale that will be low right. Activate. Okay, and this is the illustration. You can export this project, guardar como imagen, and then you can do. Sulfate distribution. Okay, and then if you go to your browser explorer. This is the software distribution, and this is this figure could be very useful if you want to do a report or like a power presentation. It's really quick and then it's almost for dummies, so like you don't need any kind of, like sometimes you deal with like in your company there is someone that only works with GIS, and then you want this has a lot of work, and then you need something quick, and then you can do this, and you can do this very easily with this tutorial. Well, that was interesting for us. Please follow us as to Jira to Hatari Water in facebook.com Hatari Water, twitter.com Hatari Water. Subscribe to this channel, and what else that you can do, like if you want to develop some tutorials, you can write me to my email. I mean, on water resources, on software to of water resources mostly. So don't like, and we can figure out what we can do for you. Okay, my name was Almontoya from Hatari Water. It was nice to talk to you today. Thank you.